Next up, we have David, who's going to talk more about VBoard, making web dashboards in 3D and VR, right?
Yeah.
You have 15 minutes. The stage is yours.
Okay, thank you. Well, first of all, thanks for coming. I'm David Moreno. I am a front developer and a researcher of Viterja, that's the company that I belong. And I'm going to talk about VBoard, that is a web application, 100% open source, as you know. And it allows to use to create dashboards and visualization in 3D and virtual reality. There is a QR there that will redirect you to the web page of the project, and I'm going to show you the web page just this is the web page that you can find information, and there is also available the slides in order to follow the QR, the QR image that I put in the slides. So, well, what's this? This is a common dashboard, of Kibana. If you know Kibana, you know that it's a tool in order to visualize data from Elasticsearch, but you can see that it's quite boring. I mean, it's just the same visualization. We have bubbles, we have pies, we have tables, we have heat maps, and we have clouds, so cloud stacks, right? So I think we are used to using this kind of visualizations, but why not take the step to another environment? I mean, for instance, the 3D environment. I don't know if you can see. Well, okay. Well, this is the aim of VBoard: to make visualizations, to make dashboards in 3D, and the possibility to get inside with virtual reality. Okay. And well, it's not the perfect image, but I think you can see it right. Well, I know that there are tools that allows to make visualization and dashboards in 3D, but the biggest problem of this kind of tools is that almost all of them are proprietary, right? So VBoard tries to compete these tools using, of course, open source. It's the right way. Using known frameworks that people are used to, high-level frameworks, you know, because it's a web. I said that it's a web application. In the web environment, in order to avoid the walled garden, okay. So the technologies that VBoard has. Is well, I said that it's a web application, so it's mainly developed with Angular, with JavaScript, HTML, CSS, right? The framework that I used was AngularJS because it's one of the common frameworks in JavaScript right now. I know that it's a little bit old, but maybe in the future we can migrate the app to React or something like that, right? It uses Elasticsearch because the VBoard is based on Kibana, right? So it uses Elasticsearch in order to visualize the data from it and to do the queries and save its state and so on. Also, of course, as I think all the web applications, it has tons of dependencies. No, I'm kidding. A lot of dependencies from NPM. And it has also two images of Docker, in order to install it in machine or wherever you want. Okay, but the most important tool or the most important framework is A-Frame. I don't know if you know A-Frame, but A-Frame is a framework that extends HTML and allows to build 3D scenes in a page just using HTML tags, right? So for instance, if we see that code, we can see that it's just HTML, but with that code, we can build extents like that, like this one, right? So it's very simple. It is based on 3, you know 3.js. And well, it's quite simple, it's quite useful, and it's the render engine of VBoard. Well, focusing on VBoard, there are many installation ways. The first one is from the repository. It has the installation steps from source code, from releases in GitHub. There are two different releases, and from Docker that it has two different images of Dockers. One that use A-Frame for render engine, and the other one that use 3.js for render engine. But as I said, A-Frame is better. This is the link to the repository in order to see more information. And when you enter to VBoard, you will see a flow of message or like that, right? This is just configuration. It's connecting to Elasticsearch, and I'm not going to stop here because I think this is not interesting for the talk. So when you are in VBoard, the first thing you will see is that. What? Without the pie, of course. And I'm going to explain the structure of the application. Well, there are a navbar at the top that has just three tabs. One, that the first one is visualize in order to make visualizations. The second one is dashboard in order to make dashboards. And the third one is show, that is used to view the dashboards in a standalone mode, right? Without any navbar, any menu, just the dashboard, okay? It's like the visualization of the dashboard, and that's it. Well, I'm going to show you how to build a visualization with VBoard, like this one, that is a 3D bar chart, and the data that I have in Elasticsearch, because you need to have installed or deployed an Elasticsearch in order to connect it and to show the data. I'm going to create a 3D bar chart. The data that I have is data related to Git commits. So we are going to represent the time evolution of the number of commits per author, right? So first of all, we have to select the index and the type of the Elasticsearch that we have. And the next one, when we click on select chart, the next form is the visualization type. There are five different visualization types on VBoard. And we are going to show a simple 3D bar chart, right? Well, you have to know how Elasticsearch aggregates the data in order to select the data that you are going to represent, right? You have to know how is the aggregation of Elasticsearch. Well, if you know it, you have to select a metric first in order to make height in the bars. And the buckets, okay, we are going to select the data in the x-axis, that will be a data histogram, for instance, monthly, of a field that has time inside, right? And the set axis will be the authors, in order to see the time evolution per authors. Well, let's click on author name, and we will see, for instance, right, 20. Okay, if we click on play, it takes a long time, okay, not a long time, sorry. And now we see a 3D visualization. That is just a 3D. And you can navigate within it, touching the arrows in the cable, or the WASD as a game. And now, well, it's just in order to see more deeply the data. Well, let's put it on Jirly in order to have less data, because we are going to save this visualization, and then we are going to add the visualization to a dashboard, right? Okay, let's click on save. Bars first name, right? Okay. Well, I think I don't have much time, so let's click on dashboard, and now we have an empty dashboard with all the visualization available. I'm going to load a dashboard that I saved before in order to go quickly. And we are going to add the visualization that we already made, right? So we are going to put, we want the visualization in front of us. So here, a little bit of height, yes, in front of us, and the set index is negative. Well, we have now our dashboard, right? There are more visualizations that I added before. And well, let's save the dashboard with the name FOSDEM. And now we are going to see the dashboard in the standalone mode. This is the dashboard in the standalone mode, right? It's just visualization. Okay. But I think the coolest way to see this dashboard is with a device that allows virtual reality. I brought here my Oculus Go. Well, it's not mine, but my Oculus Go. If you want to try one of the dashboards that I saved, please come after the talk, and I will show you how to see this kind of dashboards in virtual reality, in real virtual reality, right? And if you use a smartphone, you will see that kind of image, like when you have to use a cardboard or something like that, right? Well, you can customize your dashboard, changing the environment, rotation the chart. You can move within the dashboard. You can fly. You can get into a visualization. And I want to talk now about the latest feature that VBoard has, that is augmented reality, right? Well, before that, I'm going to explain that in the web page there are three examples from different data sources or data companies. The first one is from the company that I belong, Vitelja Data. The second one about the project Grimoire Lab, that is another open source project. And the third one is from data from the OpenStack project. So the slides are available in the web page. I'm not going to stop here because I want to show you the augmented reality of VBoard, right? If you have your smartphone here, I encourage you, please scan the QR first. I'm going to show you the video how to do that. I know that's easy. And when you scan the QR, you will redirect to a web page that will ask you for camera permissions. And if you accept it, and if you point the QR again, you will see a dashboard in augmented reality, right? I have more QRs here. If you want to try it later, I can give you some. So I think that's really impressive to see it in a paper or in a piece of paper or something like that, right? Well, there is also the link to the demo there. And well, as I said, VBoard is hosted on GitHub. It's 100% open, free, libre source. There are user guides in order to follow step by step the process to build a visualization, to build a dashboard. There are two images of Docker. You want to deploy it in wherever you want, whenever you want. And this is two links in order if you want to create a 100% libre and open source QR and markers for the augmented reality. And well, all the data that I have is
sorry to interrupt.
Okay.
Time's up. Yes.
Okay, don't
guys,
worry.
if you want to give David questions, please catch him and we'll accept.
We are also at the cafeteria,
yes,
so
yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.